His talk is about correlated quantum matter, mass transitions, unconventional superconductivity, and many more, and charge order.
Okay, do you hear me? Okay, I am Henri Alloul from Orsay, and I want to do a presentation in which I try to introduce the problem of correlated electron systems that covers the work which I have been doing for the last 30 years. So it's a different theory from the previous talk, which was the pinpoint in very recent work. Here I try to cover things which extend over a long period, and I try to introduce some concepts which are going to be discussed, I think, in the meeting next year. So, what are what can we consider as correlated quantum matter? It's essentially a series of materials which have very novel properties, which have the main point for these materials is that they are new materials which have been discovered in the antidetails, in fact, in the last 40 years. 40 years ago, this material didn't exist. So, this is a new approach of science which has started with quantum nucleates, has been really a large field which has led to get interest in systems where you have strong interaction between the electrons, and I will discuss this in more detail. And so as you see, these materials are very often layered materials. You have all these agglomerations, etc. All these are systems which are quite original in their theory. And the interesting point, of course, which has made the interesting these materials, is that they have very new emergent properties. Non-interventional superconductivity, the positive waves, spin liquids, without the delay phase, the tandem lattices are giving you different types of spin liquids. You have 1D materials, you have liquids, you have cases like over waves, you need to have large supernatural power, you have charge orders. So, many new emergent phenomena have been discovered in these materials, and that makes really the interest problem. And of course, it's hard for me to speak of all of those, but I have focused essentially on some work which have been done in my group, because I think that it allows to get a broad view of the kind situation that you encounter. Although most of the work I did on this has been mostly in the basic novelty, which is the hot insulating state and the hot transition, and I illustrate that in the case the Buddha writes, which is which has been debated for long, but it is also a work which started 30 years ago, but which has very new developments in the last 10 years. I speak of the two plates because the two plates have been really the source of many, many new phenomena, and the interest of the community has been so large in these materials that we cannot, I cannot avoid speaking about that. And then, recently, the charge of them has been restored of the two plates and has given some large developments in the last 10 years. And I'm sure that this happens in many materials. So the basic point to start with is during the last century, we have been working essentially up to the 1970 on the materials which were without strong electron correlation. And the main developments have been of the solid state physics in this period have been just the band structure type of representation with without electron interaction. And the main thing which was taken into account is the fact that when you have two nuclei, the wave function at the distance which corresponds to the position in the solid, you have different overlap of the wave functions of the different electrons of the atoms. And that leads to an integral which we call the transfer integral, which decides whether this overlap is going to permit to deodorize the electrons. And typically, the materials we were considering are such that the higher levels are the ones which give the broadest, larger overlap. And that is going to give you bands. And the bands of the electrons are very narrow for the inner electron and become large when you arrive to the balance electron. Yeah. When you do the solid, the additional picture was that it's a nuclear and full to the nuclear and not this complete electron. And of course, this thing which is very important is that this integral combines the bandwidth and stretch that. Roughly the bandwidth is given by Z2, Z is the number of numbers. And if you would change the distance between the atoms, you would change the bandwidth accordingly to the change of distance. And of course, you will get all the information about which were studied for a long time, have been the semiconductors in which the band, the gap between the bands is very small, and in which usually the bandwidths are very large, because we are in like in the case of germanium, or in the cases like single element copper, we are going to get outer band is going to be very broad, so that you can consider that the transfer integrals are very large and consequently the electrons are very large. So this kind of description, which is each in solid state physics, is that you forget anything which could be magnitude, and magnitude comes from the fact that you have some cases in which the overlaps are small. And in that case, the situation is that you have to consider the orbitals from the orbital to the element. You have to consider the orbitals, and in that case, you have to consider that if you have any transfer of electrons, you are going to pay the Coulomb interaction. much, which is very large, so that you, in fact, you can even consider that you have no correlation with your electrons, and in that case, you are going to get an atomic state which is well defined. The atomic state has levels which are such that you have large Coulomb interaction if you try to do two electrons on the same order. And if you try to do two electrons on different orders, then the Coulomb interaction is bigger. And if the balance between the two and G is going to tell you what the classical rules do, you think that you are going for this. It is as long as if you try the electrons, you are going to favor one electron per orbital. And that gives you. In which you have a permanent moment on the height. This is just pure permanent. The situation is such that if you go to the echo, sorry, to the solid, if you go to the solid, you are now in a situation that if you would like to increase the number of electrons on an orbital, you have to pay the energy U. And this energy U is such that it forbids you to localize the electron to let the electron be localized, so that you have a competition between T, which is the tendency to be localized the electron, and the U, which is the tendency to localize it. So the situation is such that if you have to consider that you take a situation, for instance, for a single orbital case, if you want to put this, one more electron on the orbital, you are going to copy the situation. So in the atom, of course, you get the level of one electron on the orbital is zero, and it's going to be zero. U for the second place. So the situation is that the beam experiment suggested by Mott is that if you are able to change the distance, you are going to modify T, leaving the U, which is in half atom energy. So if you move, you broaden the levels, and at a certain moment you are going to be able to get the localization. In fact, U is giving you the situation in which you have magnetism and charge localization, and depending whether W is smaller or larger than U, you are going to get the magnetic side of the magnetic system or the. So this mode transition is really something which has been dreamed of for a long time and which has been, some cases have been observed, and of course the simple way by which you put this mode transition is to have a compressed the material because you are going to diminish the distance between the atoms and then increase the time. This kind of transition has been advocated, and some materials has been. There are discussions about it. So what I want to show you here is that we have now in hand a system which is not an atomic system, but a molecular system, which really allows you to sample the conditions very nicely. The argument is that when you have molecular state, the interactions, the overlaps are due to Van der Waals interactions, so these are weak. And the U is weak as well, but it's easier by compressing to increase the overlap and then to enter into the mechanics. And so this is what I want to illustrate for you in the case of the Coulomb. The Coulomb is molecule with 60 electrons, and this molecule is Projekt, that you have regular articles, which you can calculate into models, and which are given to you. First, the molecular level, the last occupied so-called Bohr model as in generation, and the first non-occupied molecular model as we say that this is you can put up to 6L. Then we go to the solid, to this, the overlaps are so small that this levels keep their character. And we will look at the situation, we will see an experiment of the situation in the solid, the solid is okay. That each level keeps its actual, there is no mixing between the levels, and I just order them and get down and about half an electron volt to it. This is the comparable. So you have a little issue where you keep on molecular orbitals, you keep the electron safe as nearly as they are in the planetary. So what happens now is that we can add electrons by inserting between the C60 volt, you can enter an alkali, which is going to be, this is very common, without the alkalis are helping to load the electrons to the matrix. So, you see that you can do here something which will be an AMC60, but A is an alkali. Alkali gives electrons to the board, and once you have electrons on the board, it's going to change the nucleus of the material. And you see that 36 electrons can be housed in this plan, so you expect that any compound between A1C60 and A5C60 will be created. This is not exactly the case, but anyway, these are, you have one case which will be A60. An interesting situation in this material is that you can look this case. Operation in the consists to put a pipe and you change the distance between the holes, and you get this diagram, which I'm going to discuss in here. The starting point is that which has been really the interesting situation is one found that the physical case 60, which is this compound that you consider is insulated at ambient pressure. And when you put pressure, you see that the remaining insulator is anti-geomagnetic insulator. And when you pass 5 kilobar, which is moderate pressure for experiments, you switch into a superconducting state. And as you can see, this switch is very, very sharp. Also, this is the diamagnetic signal that you can see. Which tells you that superconductor, and as you can see, the superconductivity starts at a pressure of 5 kilobar, and below you have nearly no superconductivity. So you can measure by this way the action of superconductivity, the danger versus pressure, and you can also, by the NMR technique, you can measure the action which is not electromagnetic, so that you have real, very nice situation where the sample which is totally in the anti-electromagnetic insulator at low pressure becomes totally superconductor at low kilobar, and the very hand is very sharp first order condition from the anti-electromagnetic. So this is a very, very interesting interesting case because we check like many techniques, seminar, experience, etc. Changes on the structure. This condition is without changes at all in the structural. So this is a really what's not what thinking about. It's really the I would say probably the first time at least that we get the supercomputer in which we switch from one type of supercomputer with a very sharp transition. So the interesting point is that the measure of susceptibility in the at one bar in the finality state, you find the transition at about 47k, and you find that the susceptibility has a curie-like state, a high temperature which you can characterize. I sure about 100k, which is reasonable for a system which gets an anti-permanent at 50k. And we find an effective moment which is small. It's small in the sense that it corresponds roughly to spin 1/2. And the spin 1/2 is not what you expect because you have 3 electrons. This is cesium 2. You have 3 electrons on the ball, so you would expect in naively a 3/2. In fact, you find a 1/2. And that tells you that something like that happens, which means that the state where you put 3 electrons on the ball has modified the electronic structure of the ball. In fact, what can understand quite nicely is that when you put electrons on the ball, you change the symmetry of the ball. So the naive calculation using the problematic structure in which you consider that the ball is not modified is wrong. In fact, you have a distortion because you got from the electrons to the C60 frame of nuclei, and that performs the deformation
the blue curve corresponds to the spectrum between the
in the 1980s, that was considered, and magnetism was considered to be like that, to the thing that is supercomputing. You didn't expect anything to happen except that the North is here, this kind of matter, and everybody has been. High DC compounds past the 77 day line of the living nitrogen, and this has been a new discovery which has created a lot of hope that one would be able to produce a new spectrum of GDP, a full temperature, or even a nitrogen temperature. This is not that it is the only thing which works quite nicely is that because I'm probably of this matter that one is now able to do to show to run to the value of supercomputing quite nicely, where students can play around with it without having to compute it. So when the point that where comes this, what are the materials in which you have this computing? The main point is that these materials are not working through. That is, if you have one electron per quarter, this is in the quarter oxygen level, that is in the genome, if you have one electron per quarter, you get an anti-ferromagnet insulator, and this is in the insulator. And you need to know the brain system to be superconducting. Big difference between the cesium 366 and the other plates is that in one case, the high superconductivity just by the contraction of the atoms and the radio pressure. In this case, you have to know and you have all the proper ways to get superconductivity. So we have here again a system which is mostly with strong correlations, but we don't know whether strong correlation has been one of the big questions. And like you say, that the acquaintance diagram of the people is well known, that is here again, you have an electromagnetic state, and when you go, you switch to a supermagnetic state, in which we before of the long time ago, was that this happens in the situation in which the field susceptibility as measured by NMR has a drop which occurs well above CC and with which given the existence of some kind of phasing of the skin, the freedom of disappearance of them, which signals line which we have called the line, and it shows the phase diagram in the case of the wave. And we have a new line in the phase diagram which tells you that you begin to lose speed susceptibility before reaching DC. Of course, when you reach DC, you probably lose the speed susceptibility, the remaining part of the speed susceptibility, because you are reaching the situation where but still you have lost a lot well before, and that tends to be clear. You have strong correlations playing the role, so that main idea which was advocated at that time was that this was a sign of what we did before. And we point very early on an experiment which I think was very definitive, which maybe has not been definitive. We just added four percent zinc on the proper side. And if you do that, you can do a phase diagram with equal plus 4%. And you see immediately that you slightly decrease the anti-coronavirus regime. You get a large range of where you have a big disorder of magnetism, but you depress a lot superconductivity. So that you have people the gene where you have totally killed superconductivity, but what you find is that the market doesn't change, so you have really the pseudo that remains, and we did experience using electron radiation to create effects in which you have to transport. You see, in the day that this line is absolutely unmodified by disorder. Why the superconductivity is very strong. In this experiment, you said was telling me that the two phenomena, which is the superconductivity, are affected differently by the order, and that tells you that it is rather a short range order phenomenon because it remains even when you put the word of the order, and why this one is a long time. Okay, so this pseudo gap has been seen in the So I come back to the system. I show immediately from the MR that this is S wave. And the behavior of the ions are exponential and allows you to get the gap. And if you see that there are some measurements in the future, you can check what is the ions in the problem. This is a community at TC and of the gap. As you can see, it's a community at TC in the instance when you go towards the most position, and this is a harmonic which tells you. The gap is precisely telling you that you use before HTC rather in the ID. So here we have not to the gap sign, and we have the gap which increases while the HTC goes up. While here the ratio at high pressure of very dense materials corresponds to about the factor of expected to get it back to 2.5 BTC in the situation. And here you reach the high dynamic equation to get that other 5 times to get back to 5. So we have here the sign that things are happening when you affect the condition because of the weight of the correlation is increasing, and this is the case which is clean experience. I have no time to be details of this or this. I would like to say that in the big way, at least the most side that I just need. Here we measure the bounded nice way to determine the superconductivity situations. What we define is that superconductivity situations follow the gap, follow the TC, and the computing on the pseudo gap. So all these tensors that we need the pseudo gap and the superconductivity are really important. I want to run the charge order now. And the charge order is something which has been sort of 10 years ago in the UK, and the in the pseudo gap machine in the envelope foundation. There's a time that you have a chart order which can be observed by the car or the computer. I'm not able to do this. This has been done for years. You find it by experiment. The main point I have here about it for a very long time is that if you look at the pseudo gap onset, you find that when you reach situations where you have this kind of chart order which never exceed about 150 k, you already have lost 50% of the susceptibility, which tells you that the total gap can be vulnerable for all these problems. So the actual configuration of the phase diagram which is produced is telling you that apart from the total gap line, you have a range of ordering which are in fact always well below the total gap regime. It means that there are, in some sense, consequences of the total gap. And the fact that they want to advocate is that this type of ordering that are detected in this kind of experiments are really governed by the fact that the systems are blocked, not insulators, and they are blocked with insulators. That means you have to do chemistry to block them, and you have chemical block. And I want to indicate that my opinion, that I think many people now begin to agree with this idea that these charge orders are not connected to interconductivity, they are in fact are competing with interconductivity, they have a tendency to reduce this thing. Second, they are not generic, that means they are very much dependent on the system. The kind of operating that we get depends very much on the system and on the chemistry which needs to be looked at. To respect that point, I want to indicate very rapidly in the system on which I have been working also for the last 10 years, I've been working on the sodium cobalt. These are the layer system, cobalt. And you use sodium to go to cobalt depleted layers. You put sodium between the layers and you feed the electrons in the layers, so you have the metallic states induced back here. And these are 300 lattices, so there is an interest. And one thing which is quite clear, and you see quite early, is that the sodium order. That is, you have an order depending on the concentration of. And we have the joint experiments which are extremely interesting because we have shown that we can isolate different cases very finely on the concentration doing the NPR spectra. You can see that the NPR spectra are very much dependent on the concentration, and in fact, you have. We have four cases, 67, 71, 72, the number of tensions, and the X for any X, is the concentration of sodium. And so you see that here, you have spectra which are totally orthogonal to each other, and if you are in between 71 and 72, which is 1% difference, you have a spectrum which is the superposition of the string that you have in your face. So you can. And in these materials, you very nice phases which are pure in a given phase. We keep that in powders and in our measurements on that. You see, the point is that when you do your computation, you want that the total oxygen plane is a plane. You don't care about what's happening outside. You want it to be an isolated plane, and you don't care what is the role of the extra atoms that you have in the structure. But for us, the chemistry is very small. In the case of the future plane, you find that you have 3 sites of sodium, 4 sites of cobalt. You can even do, for many of our measurements, we were able to decide the structure, and you do find on the cobalt sites are very different. On the electronic focus, you have two of the sites which are susceptible to the balance of temperature, two models have a very large temperature standard, which is very similar. You have two sites which are magnetic and which are normal. So you have a situation in which the levels have been split by the perception. The TQG level is full, 22 is level which has mostly normal. And when you put some balls, you get the TQG band, and then you get normal. So the situation that we have shown today, left here in that case, is that the behavior of the different places is quite, quite different. Some have dynamic perceptivity, one is organized dynamically, the two other ones are in between in their behavior. And more recently, we have been drawing single pupils with the same concentration, well controlled. But also the oligo are very, very different. One thing the oligo is negative as an interior of the organ structure. All this is a positive. We have very conditions which are very well characterized nowadays. And I just finished with that, that we are able to do the measure. For the oscillation is a mix kind of sample, so we learn about the dynamic perspective and we are encouraged to be able to characterize the condition in this last sample, which has been generalized with the kind of thing that happens. So we observe that we have a very good case of modifying condition with superconductivity. And we will talk about behavior, which is quite original in superconductivity. The two phase, we have this developed phase, which is not well understood at all at this stage, but at least all the things that have been followed over the last 10 years, about the charge or whatever, are not that essential. We are interesting because we have a competition between each travel, let's say, and the people, but they are not involved in so much in the performance. What I have shown is that when you have to go what is better, you have to do some things, you have to do things. So I think that what one has to isolate the problems and in the case of the details, the main problem is the sonograph and its relationship to the waters. Sorry for being wrong.
Thank you. Let me start. So what do you think? What is actually the relation between the mass transition and the superconductivity? For instance, in cesium-3 260, you have the optimum pressure away from the MOPS first order transition. Well, so how is it related? What's your feeling?
Disappears when you become on that line. There is a continuity. You cannot speak of a dome, there is a weak dome, you see. But when you are on that line, you switch to a superconductor in a I think that dopants play a role in the way the dome goes down. The dome is not, in my opinion, it's not that, not that general. What it is to move even higher towards the base and to help them by that. So, already, it's not possible. And I think you can learn about these other ways. Either these order or order, and both of them are dependent of the supercomputing. So there is a difference in the technical domain.
It's easy to you have just a pressure dome, so it might be a cleaner face. And I still wonder what
this is. This is what they want to take. This is what they want to take.
Another question.
Similarity between the theories like Gaussian movement, which is an expansion by magnetic insulator and then becomes metallic and paramagnetic with pressure and then deconducting with more pressure. And is there similar physics going on there? And what's going on?
Yes,
so about bipolar, the inverted transition happens when it goes down and then high
pressure.
It's not my work.
No, okay. Bipolar, what has happened? It might be different because this case is supposed to be a keyword for something, but I think that's already a good case. You have S-ray case in the system. So, is it known how the mode transition is affected by different zones? In the season 360, we feel we have no difference.
I'm thinking about open.
In the pure plate. But you don't have a mode transition. You have this is the, I call mode transition the transition which is induced by pressure. Okay? For me, the pure plate is induced by density. And if, of course, if you consider the phase diagram of the different pure plates, you know that they are not the same. You know that the intermediate phases in the L2CO4 or the expansion, you know that these intermediate phases are rather situation where you could think of stripes. In the B-plates, you have things which are more 2D, like in the eco. We don't know what happens very well in the case of the metal compound, etc., etc. So each system has instabilities towards the charge-order state. The charge-order state which compete with the
photograph. It would be nice to point out that the charge-order state is at the low of the sun. So that is something which is present in all of it. So,
But the charge order is in any of the dependent on the density of the body. So, this is the message.
Okay, further question specifically to this talk here? Yes, please.
So, you said you learned anything about the likely nature of preparing goo from the works. We always talk about preparing goo for the supernatural case. Can you say anything from your clinical works on what might be
I am not sure I am able to say anything about that myself. I think the people who treat the rebound model indicate that there is some limit of what you are going to do, which is inherent to the rebound model itself. And so, I'm not sure what is the truth. I think the G-wave argument, the fact that it's G-wave, in the strong argument about saying that when you put electrons on the different orbitals, that can explain the G wave. This was the argument for the G wave on the Newton. But honestly, we need to. We have many. They should solve that.
Okay, so let's conclude this discussion and thank Henri again. And it seems we are heading right into the next discussion, I think a discussion on the general topic of frontiers of condensed matter. Is that right? Is that what I can have in mind? Shall we discuss the new horizons, current problems, wish list on what's urgent to do, or more thoughts about...
Can we have something that connects us?